Cap is so passionate about this, she lost her earbud, and she's cutting her hair.
Gradually losing the brain.
We're in a decline. Are we sure Sidar was not fainted? I'm just asking.
Okay.
Welcome to Reading the Pattern. Let's get to another fiery video from my collaboration with the Black Tower Podcast, Wheel Talk, and Fantology. Now, be sure you don't miss my other video from this conversation where the panel clashes over Fayil and her arc in The Wheel of Time. Let me warn you up front, these videos do contain spoilers for the entire series, so please skip these if you're avoiding spoilers and go to my spoiler-free playlist instead. Overall, I have to say, the guys from the Black Tower, Andrew, Josh, and Daniel, are incredibly gracious hosts, more than willing to bring on panelists who have wildly different opinions and just give us the platform to stir things up, and we did. My fellow guests were Rakapa Sadai from Wheel Talk here on YouTube and Steven from the Fantology podcast, and it was really great fun to get to collaborate with both of them for the first time as well. In this video, it was my turn to create chaos as I make the argument that Gawyn's arc in The Wheel of Time is not as bad as a lot of fans think it is.
It's because we're talking controversial opinions tonight. I mean, like, literally everything we've said is controversial. Mm-hmm. I've already went out there on a limb and said that Perrin and Fayil is one of the better relationships in The Wheel of Time.
You did.
But
it's true.
So... the controversial thing I wanted to say is that I don't think Gawyn is anywhere near the worst character arc. And that's not to say anything about him as a character, because he's easily the most annoying character.
yes.
But his arc, it's not great, but it's definitely not the worst. Why is Gawyn not the worst arc, even though he might be the worst? But his arc is not that bad. His arc is kind of interesting, and it's one of maybe the only ones in the series that's on, like, a downward arc, right? Like, he starts off much better, and then where he ends up is, like, he's, like, spirals downward, basically. So he kind of stands out to me in the whole overall narrative for the direction that he goes as a character is different. And that's interesting. Where it's a little bit weak is just that some of the things that he does are not always, they don't always seem justified. So, like, I don't know why he stays with Elida for that long. Like, I don't know what he's doing. And I don't entirely feel like it's justified that he hates Rand as much as he does, even though people he supposedly trusts, like, tell him things that he should listen to. So there's parts of his arc that we just don't get enough there to, like, make it make sense. But, like, the overall trajectory of it, I do think is interesting, and I do hope that, like, the show kind of keeps it broad strokes, a lot of the same things there, but that we fill in some of those things that don't make sense and make it work and make it more of, like, a tragic arc. And that he's, like, on sort of, like, an opposite arc of Rand, maybe. It's, it's an opposing direction to go in. And if it was justified, if you understood why he did what he did at all those steps, even though you want to smack him in the face, it would still be entertaining and interesting. So that's my argument for why he is definitely not the worst arc. He's not the best, like, not the best arc. I'm not trying to say that.
I had to take out a tangent on Min here, which was entirely my fault, but it did lead to the video I did recently on Min's arc, which you should also check out. And if you want that part of the conversation, be sure to check out the entire thing on the Black Tower podcast. Now, let's get to Josh's initial reaction to my argument.
If we're discussing Gawyn, which I believe we are, either that or I've drank too much.
I mean, it
Gawyn's
might be
Gawyn's character arc. Now, I expressed my opinion on this in the last panel we did, titled Unpopular Opinions of the Wheel of Time. And my opinion of Gawyn is that he and Elaine are the same character. And I hold to that. They are both extremely privileged youths who have an extremely narrow set view of the world, because it's the world that they were introduced to. I am royalty, ergo, people listen to me because I am royalty. We see this when Gawyn storms Gareth Bryn's camp to go talk to Gareth Bryn in, I believe it's the Gathering Storm. But I'd like to say this for Gawyn. As far as the character, he is true to his character. From point A, when we're introduced to Gawyn, to point Z, when the story ends, Gawyn acts like Gawyn. Gawyn does Gawyn things. He never does anything that anybody goes, oh, that's out of character.
So doesn't that mean he has a terrible arc?
He has a terrible arc. I'm sorry. That's what I was building up to. So yeah, he's Gawyn.
Also, just FYI, for reference, in that particular panel, he was outvoted, saying that
everybody
and
loves
Gawyn
Elaine,
were the same apparently. Character.
Everyone loves Elaine?
I think we apparently. Actually did come down to the fact that Gawain's not as bad as he is made to be.
He is, though.
Wait, however, why is that? No.
I love Gawyn,
that Elaine and Gawyn,
but he's a big dumb idiot.
Now, Stephen had come in prepared to argue that Gawyn had the worst arc, but he also had an interesting perspective on where he wanted Gawain's arc to go.
Stephen, tell me why I'm right, Stephen.
You're not. Oh my God, that was amazing.
Thank you, Stephen.
We're just no. We're
no,
not.
No, 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 no.
We're not going to get into this. All right, no, all right. We're going to have a real conversation about this.
Stephen, hit it.
I was ready to say, I was ready to go with Gawyn was my worst arc, actually. I pulled back at the last minute. Maybe I don't think he's quite the worst anymore, but I just think that he should have been bad. His arc would have been better if he had gone full on to the dark and he became some kind of like minion forsaken or something. He kind of did. And he kind of had this redemption arc where he was like, I hate Rand. And then by the end, he's like, okay, I understand what's going on a little bit. And then he sacrifices himself.
I don't even
foolishly.
Know who you are.
But the problem is, it's not really a redemption arc because he didn't ever really do anything like all that bad. And I think it just would have been cooler if he had gone full on evil. And then by the end, he came back around in some way. And I don't think there's enough of that in Wheel of Time. Like, there's not enough good characters going to the bad side and bad characters going to the good side. That's just one thing I wish there was more of in the Wheel of Time.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
That's a good
like in major ones that we get are Asmodian and Mazrim. Those are the two.
Not even.
But they're all bad guys that are still just
they're,
because
I was
they
gonna
are
say,
bad
like, not
guys.
Even. You can't count those.
Doesn't
you can't
mean
count
they
them.
Are bad guys.
I mean, yeah. I can. Just because you disagree doesn't mean that I don't have the ability.
No, Steve, I
think say Mazrim's name is a good guy. You're going to get
probably the most potent point of the evening. There are no character arcs that go from good to
there bad are very few
bad to good.
Yeah.
Daniel surprised me a little bit in his take, but he brought in the question of how realistic Gawyn's arc is.
So I actually agree with you on this one. I actually don't think that Gawyn's that bad. I jump into the Gawyn is super fun to make fun of. Gawyn is super fun to throw under the bus. 100%. When people go ahead and bring up Gawyn, I'm always like, yeah, no, 100%. Gawyn's trash. Because it's fun to say, and when it comes right down to it, Gawyn is not a good character. So it's easy to jump on that. But at the same time, I definitely would not say that Gawyn is the worst character. Because again, I feel like two things are true. Number one, his character arc is believable. I believe
that's
Gawyn's character arc. The fact that he actually has a really hard time going ahead and getting out of his stubborn princely nature, the fact that he has a really hard time going ahead and sloughing off this first impression of Rand that he has, especially when he immediately love at first sights in some ways Egwene, who he seems to think is like Rand's girl. The fact that he doesn't ask enough questions and the fact that he doesn't communicate to enough people is stupid. It's the dumbest thing I've ever seen in my life.
No one in the Wheel of Time communicates.
Come but on, he's well, also not even able to communicate. Exactly, but that is like hallmark
he
Wheel of Time.
He doesn't believe
and
anyone.
And it's so a hallmark Gawyn. Because he just thinks that what his first impression is the right one. And he has such a hard time getting out of those. And so right. I think that again, when we're talking about character arcs, I might actually argue that Gawyn has one of the worst ones because he doesn't grow very well and he doesn't grow very significantly. But at the same time, I think that one of the things that we need to talk about in character arcs is, does that make sense? Does their character arc make sense that they don't grow? That they actually are the same person point. Between beginning to end? And Gawyn, to me, I would almost be more angry with him having this amazing redemption arc and almost having this whatever, because he was never gonna turn evil. I don't actually believe Gawyn as an evil character. I don't believe Gawyn as this like amazingly heroic redemptive character. I believe him as a minor princeling who has never actually achieved anything in his life because he has a sister who is set to do everything for him and a brother who's better at everything he's trying to do. And so the fact that he ends up just being a middling character from beginning to end makes so much sense to me.
Yeah, poor guy.
But wait for it, because Rekappa is going to go off.
Poor guy.
Are we supposed to feel sorry for him?
No.
Are we supposed to feel sorry for him? This little
boy. You can feel however you want about
Gawyn. Everyone comes up. Everyone says to him, everyone's like, you are married to the Ammerlin. You are now bounded to the Ammerlin. Everything you do, you are responsible for her. And he doesn't give a flying. He doesn't care. And we're supposed to feel sorry for this little bitch of a boy who couldn't accept that even though his mother is still alive, oh, Rand still killed her. Oh, I'm still going to cling to this. I can't. I'm sorry.
Wait, but no one feels sorry for him. Who feels sorry for him?
I think we're nobody feels sorry for him. Isn't it more of a pity thing, almost?
Yeah, I think I would say pity is a better word. Rekappa.
It's not that I actually necessarily feel sorry for him, but I understand him. There is
Rekappa,
a difference there.
I think
I am empathetic, even if I don't agree with any of his choices.
This is someone we were supposed to be able to trust. This is a trick hand. This is someone who, from the beginning of the series, we were supposed to get excited about. We were supposed to believe, oh, wow, this boy has superior abilities. And then he runs up to Demandrid because he's too much of a little bitch to accept the fact that he might not be the one to kill the Forsaken. And then he gets his ass killed. Sorry, Gawyn, that's what happens when you're a dumbass.
Knowing that he's bonded to Egwene and the consequences of that decision.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he does it anyway.
Gawyn.
Does it anyway. Doesn't care. Doesn't care.
Now, Andrew does not see much change in Gawyn from the beginning to the end.
As far as arcs go, you know, when you think arc, you think like the St. Louis arc, you think the arcs are like roller coasters. Gawyn has as much arc as the bumper car ride at a carnival. He has as much character development as you get graduating from fourth grade going to fifth grade. He is the exact same.
It's not
same.
A graduation. It's a promotion. He's going from the first grade to the second grade. It's insanity. This is not about you.
He is the same tag along, follow along, sad toddler tantrum giving character. And when we first meet him, as he is when we last see him, I can't do what I want, so I'm going to throw a tantrum to get what I think I want because I know best for me and I don't. There's only three good things. I said this last panel. So Daniel, y'all know something. There's only three good things.
Oh, I know exactly what
that Gawyn does. So. Ring one, ring two, Faith. Ring three, oh die. Worst character I have ever read, ever been exposed to. Written well for the character that he's supposed to be so bad as. But just such a shite character and character art. I can't even call it a character art. It's like a flat road that goes nowhere. He went off into the West and died behind Lewis and Clark.
So I have to make my points clearer here, and some minds are blown again.
Oh, shit.
Don't you think he's significantly worse at the end than he was at the beginning? Because that's what I'm arguing.
Oh, wait
Rebecca,
is that you saying
that's not an arc?
Are you saying his character arc is going from here?
No, because that arc implies that there was ever
that arc. Was all your argument. Josh, did you not get that?
You're so right. That, no, Rebecca brings up a great point, because when Elaine takes him out on the boat and she's like, oh my God, Gawyn, you shouldn't be thinking like this. You have a real issue with the way you think. Gawain's like, no, I'm a Trakan, whatever, nothing matters. And Elaine, who, I'm not an Elaine fan, but Elaine is the one who's like, no, you are not thinking straight. And he doesn't listen.
Piece of shit.
I mean, he doesn't. So if he does drop off, my God.
My argument is just first off, apologies to Rebecca because I completely misunderstood what you were saying.
Yeah, so an arc doesn't have to be like this character from makes here progress. To here, they get better.
It could be from here to here. And
yeah,
exactly.
In that sense, I'm 100% on board. Like, oh my God.
I don't think it's that much different than we see him at the beginning. It could be better. It's when you're in like middle school and you fall in love with this girl or this guy or whoever you fall in love with, and I'd do anything for you. Let me write you a letter that says that I would jump in front of bullets for you. I'd put on blood knife rings for you. I'd sacrifice my life.
I would put on all the blood knife.
He's naive enough, childish enough, and never grew up or down enough to be selfish enough or to be logical enough to see that everything he's doing is still the same shit he would have done at the beginning of the book. In the exact same scenario with the exact same motivators. If he was already in love with Egwene at the start of the book, he probably would have put on the blood knife rings, I don't know, first chance he got, hopefully book three, and we wouldn't have to deal with him ever again.
You know what? Egwene, I gotta say, when it comes to now it's time to take the vote, right? And I gotta say, God, as far as character arcs go, when we put the added filter on from the here to here, and we talk about a decline with a character arc, I gotta say, God, Gawyn guts it for me, man. Like, he does, he is definitely worse at the end than he was in the beginning.
It's a small decline,
here
but
you go.
Tragic decline arc. It could be better, but it's there. And
that's where I'm with you. I actually think that Gawyn is an incredibly tragic character. Yes. And so he has an arc. It's not an arc that anybody likes.
No.
It's
but
not
is
a good
the
arc
of
that
tragedy enough
wants?
For you to give it a thumbs up.
But who the f watches but no Hamlet change. And likes the character of Hamlet? It's a tragedy.
No, Hamlet
there's a reason.
Okay, actually,
so
quite
a trash. Hamlet,
does
the character is so bad.
A good
like,
character
again,
arc or no? Yes or no?
It's a tragic character arc. I am absolutely giving it a thumbs up. Okay. I think that it is a good arc for a bad character.
I'll give you a
Recapa,
thumbs up.
Steven, what do you think?
I'm sorry. I'm still a no, guys.
What I'm giving a thumbs up to.
I understand.
If you're asking me to give a thumbs up to something frustrating that engages me in the series, I will give you a thumbs up.
Yes.
You know what?
Steven, you had thoughts.
Steven, give us your thoughts.
I don't think it's an arc. I think it's a line. I think it's a line from one point to another point, and it goes down. And so I get the argument now.
No, he's not drawing it like this. He's drawing it like that. There is no
right.
Arc. It's okay. Right
here. Fair.
It's a very, very tragic, boring, annoying.
It's tragic, but it's not tragic enough.
In Andor, and I met this farm boy, and hi, I'm Gawyn, the dumbass who puts on all the blood knife rings.
It's that, exactly.
Even though I know for a fact that it's going to kill my wife.
I could see that as an arc. I see it more of a line. I wish it was more tragic is my thing. Got so it. I'm a thumbs down, but I do get the argument more now.
I agree it should be more tragic, and I hope the show does a little bit more with it because it's not as good as it should be, but there's some good elements there.
I'm definitely not convincing Andrew or Steven. And I will say the attempted downward spiral tragic arc of Gawyn does have some weaknesses. But I like the idea of it, and I think with some tweaks and some more development, it has the potential to be a really compelling tragic arc. And that's the potential I see and the direction that I hope the Wheel of Time TV show will go in for Gawyn. I hope you enjoyed these conversations as much as I did, and if so, please check out the full conversation. I have links to all of my fellow content creators in the description. Please go check out and watch and listen to more of their content. Thank you, Black Tower Podcast. Thank you, Wheel Talk. Thank you, Fantology.